This brings us to electrostatic energy. The energy stored in a system of charges is equal to the amount of work it took to bring them into that system from infinitely far away. So think of it this way. We begin with a number of charges so far apart that they can't detect one another. None of these charges experiences any force due to the other charges. They're all just floating out there on their own. Then we grab one charge, Q1, and pull it into our system. This doesn't take any work because it's the only charge in the system. There's no existing field in the system to push or pull at it. But when we go to pull a second charge, Q2, into the system, it does experience a force because of the field around the charge that's already there. The work it takes to pull in this charge is equal to Q2 times the voltage V21, the voltage Q2 experiences because of Q1. Then suppose we pull in a third charge, Q3. This charge will experience the superposition of a voltage due to the first charge, Q1, and a voltage due to the second charge, Q2. So the work required to pull in this third charge is Q3 times the sum of V31 and V32. This pattern will continue for each consecutive charge. Each will experience the sum of the voltages due to all the charges brought in before. For our three-charge system, the total work is this. Charge Q2 times V21, the voltage Q2 experiences due to Q1, plus Q3 times V31, the voltage Q3 experiences due to Q1, plus Q3 times V32, the voltage Q3 experiences because of Q2. This expression is true, but we can get a much nicer representation by playing with the math a bit. First, note that if we do the same process in reverse, bringing in Q3 first, then Q2, then Q1, we get this also true expression. Then if we add those two equations and divide both sides of the resulting equation by 2, we get this. This is a much nicer expression for the solution to the total electrostatic energy stored in a system of n point charges. It is equal to 1/2 the summation for all point charges of the product of the charge and the voltage that charge experiences due to all other charges in the system. Again, we can use the principle of superposition to obtain integral-based expressions for other possible charge distributions, as shown here.